So control system. Syllabus of control system. So syllabus of control system in has first part as we'll look at transfer function, block diagram, and signal flow graph. Then we will go for time domain analysis. Then we will look at stabilities. For stabilities, we have different techniques. The techniques are classified into two parts: time domain techniques and frequency domain techniques. The time domain techniques are RH criteria, or root locus. Then frequency domain techniques are Bode plot or Nyquist plot. So we will look at all these four techniques. Then we will go for state space analysis. And then we will conclude our syllabus for compensators or controllers. So this is the entire syllabus of control systems. Next we will, I'll give you the few standard textbooks which can be used. So standard textbooks, first is Control System Engineering by Nagarath Gopal. Then second I have Automatic Control System B.C. Kuo, and you can also use Modern Control System by Ogata. So these are the standard textbooks which can be used to study the control system. So let us begin the syllabus, and the weightage of this subject is from, it varies again from 6 to 8 marks every year. The questions of control system are very easy. So therefore, I would recommend the students to please study the subject thoroughly so that you can easily attempt the questions in GATE. The questions coming from the subjects are easy, and it is one of the scoring subjects from GATE point of view. Next, let me start the syllabus. First of all, what is a control system? So control system is nothing but a group of system components. So group of system components, control system is group of system components which are arranged to give desired output. This is very important. Desired output. It gives desired output. It does not give input, but it gives desired output. Now, control system can be classified into two types. So, the control systems are classified into two types. One is open loop system, open loop, and the other is closed loop. The open loop system can be shown graphically. So schematically, the open loop system can be shown like this. It has a controller, and then it has a plant. So here you apply input, and here you get output. This is open loop system. Then by applying feedback, you can make it a closed loop system. So what is feedback? Feedback is nothing but application. You take a part of output and apply it back to the input. So closed loop system can be schematically shown as, so this is again controller, and you have process or plant here. Then you apply a feedback network in this case. So feedback network. So this is feedback network. So here you have output and here you have input. Now, so whenever there is change in output due to change in certain conditions or certain external conditions, the output will change. And whenever output changes, the feedback will take the difference of this reference input and feedback and will generate an error signal. So based on error signal, this controller will control the output. And in this way, we get desired output. So this is the difference between open loop system and closed loop system. So in open loop system, you do not have feedback. So if by some means, and I mean, if by some reason the output changes, then you cannot control it. So in open loop system, the output cannot be controlled in any way. So, but in closed loop transfer function, closed loop system, by applying a feedback, you can get the desired output. Next, we will look at the transfer function. Now, let us start the syllabus. First of all, we will go for transfer function. So, what is a transfer function? Transfer function is nothing but, so transfer function. So, let me consider an example. So here I have V2 and V1. Here I have V1 and V2. Here I have R1, R2. Here I have R, and this is 1 by SC. This is an S domain. Now the transfer function is nothing but ratio of output by input. So therefore, if you find here V2 by V1, it is R2 by R1 plus R2. And here the V2 by V1 will be equal to 1 by SC by R plus 1 by SC, which comes out to be 1 by 1 plus SRC. So what do you observe here is, and where this RC is called as time constant. So you can write this as 1 by 1 plus S tau. So if you compare both the diagrams, you do not have any memory element here. So memory element is 1, which stores the energy. So here capacitor. So capacitor and inductor are memory elements, where a resistor is a memoryless element. So in this particular system, we do not have any memory element. So you did not get any poles and zeros. But here you observe that the order of the system is 1, the order of the system is 0. So always remember, the order is nothing but the number of memory elements present in the or storage elements present in the network. So this is an important point, because here you have a capacitor, and capacitor is a memory element. So therefore the order of the system comes out to be 1, whereas the order of this system is 0. So the important point here is the order of a transfer function, the order of a transfer function is equal to the number of storage elements present in the network. Next, now let me define transfer function. So I'll give you two definitions. So definition number one says that the transfer function is nothing but the ratio of Laplace transform of output divided by Laplace transform of input with initial conditions equal to 0. So transfer function is Laplace transform of output divided by Laplace transform of input with 0 initial conditions. Now why the initial condition should be 0? Because this definition is for LTI systems. So this definition is for LTI systems. So the transfer function which we have defined here, the definition which we have given, it is applicable for LTI systems. LTI systems are linear time invariant systems. So if you do not make initial condition 0, then the system will become non-linear. So initial condition makes the system non-linear, and therefore they must be 0. Then second definition is definition number 2. Definition number 2 says that the transfer function is nothing but it is Laplace transform of impulse response. Now what is impulse response? So if there is a LTI system, if there is an LTI system and if you apply an input to it, if you apply impulse input to it, if you apply del of t, then whatever output you get is called as impulse response. So for the output of a LTI system, for impulse input is called as impulse response. Now there is a, now this definition, the definition number 2 actually is a derivation of definition number 1. How? So if you consider the transfer function in general, in control system we will take the transfer function to be C of S divided by R of S, where C of S is nothing but the Laplace transform of output and R of S is nothing but the Laplace transform of input. So C of S by R of S. Now if you apply the input as del of t, so if R of t, that is input, is del of t, then R of S will be equal to 1. Is this clear? So R of S must be equal to 1. I guess this point is clear to the students, that when you apply input as impulse to an LTI system, whatever response of the system I get is called as impulse response, and for impulse input R of S is equal to 1. So therefore the transfer function is only C of S, which is nothing but the Laplace transform of output. So the what will be output in this case? H of t ka Laplace transform, the Laplace transform of H of t. And therefore the second definition actually follows from the first definition. But remember both the definition. The first definition says that it is the Laplace ratio of Laplace transform of output divided by Laplace transform of input. And the second definition says that the transfer function is nothing but the Laplace transform of impulse response. Next, I'll give you a very important terminology here, that is called as the time constant form of a system. Time constant form of a system. So what is time constant form? So for example, C of s by R of s is my transfer function. It is also represented by G of s. Generally, C of s by R of s is, it is closed loop transfer function. It is called as closed loop transfer function. We'll look at it just after a while. And this is called as open loop transfer function. G of s is represented by, G of s is called as open loop transfer function. Now, so in general, a transfer function in time constant form is denoted by, is denoted as this, 1 plus k into 1 plus s tau 1, 1 plus s tau 2, and so on, divided by s power n into 1 plus s tau a into 1 plus s tau b, and so on. So in general, this is the time constant form of a transfer function. In this, this k is called as system gain. K is called as system gain. Then n is called as the type of system. Type of system. So this n is called as type of system. And what is type of system? Type of system is nothing but poles at origin. Poles at origin. And remember that this k, system gain, is defined only in time constant form. It is the constant in time constant form. You cannot take otherwise. And the total number of poles gives you the order of the transfer function. Order of transfer function. So always remember that order is greater than or equal to type, because type is nothing but poles at origin, whereas order contains poles at origin as well as the finite poles also. The poles at other locations also. So therefore, the total number of poles gives you the order of transfer function, whereas the poles at origin will give you the type of system. Next, let me consider an example. The example is, find the system gain, comma, type and order for C of s divided by R of s is equal to 10 into s plus 5 whole square divided by s cube into s plus 2 whole square into s plus 10. So this is the given transfer function to me. Now the type of this system, so I have to calculate system gain, type and order for this particular system. Okay, so first of all, the type of the system is 3, because there are 3 poles at origin. So type can be directly calculated. Then what is the order of the system? Order is nothing but total number of poles. So total number of poles is nothing but order, and it is 6. Now to calculate the value of system gain k, what I'll do is, I'll convert this particular transfer function into time constant form first. It is not in time constant form, so never consider k as 10, as generally students think that k is 10, k can be considered 10 directly, but do not consider 10, k to be 10, because the particular transfer function is not in time constant form. So first of all, what you have to do is, you have to convert that given transfer function into time constant form. So to do that, what I'll do is, I'll write C of s by R of s is equal to, just take 5 common from the numerator, so you'll get into 5 square into 1 plus s by 5. I'll write it bottom at the down. Okay, so C of s by R of s is equal to 10 into, I'll get 5 square here, so which is 1 plus s by 5 whole square divided by, here I'll get s cube. So I'll take 2 common and here from here 10 common. So it will be 2 square into 10 s cube into 1 plus s by 2 whole square into 1 plus 10 by s. So this is the transfer function now. Now 10 and 10 gets cancelled and you have 25 by 4 as the value of k. So here this is the, now the constant which appears is nothing but k. So k is 25 divided by 4. So in this way, so please make a note of this. This is very important because generally student make this mistake. So please try to avoid this.